My stomach was hurting before. I don't know how that happened. I've been traveling a lot, and then like I didn't feel nervous about coming out here because I trust you people, and I think we're okay. But like maybe my stomach was, I don't know. Like I've always been an anxious, nervous person, and I would have psychosomatic events. Is that the word? Did I ever tell you that story about how I cured being a hypochondriac? Do you know that story? That's a good story. My father was a doctor, which means I was a hypochondriac. How else are you going to get their attention? Now, am I going to tell? Okay, let's do it. When you grow up with a dad who's a doctor, you have access to other doctors. And, well, here's the story. I was at college. I was a sophomore in college. And somewhere about a month or so before Christmas break, I decided that I had MS. So I started calling my father. I'm like, Dad, I have MS. And he's like, you don't have MS. I'm like, how do you know? How do you know? You haven't examined me? I don't know how you would know that. He goes, I know you don't have MS. He goes, what are your symptoms? I'm like, I don't know. My hands are tingly. He's like, you don't have MS. Are you drinking coffee? I'm like, I drink coffee. It's probably coffee. He's like, no, I have MS. And then, okay. So he hangs up. And then like a couple weeks later, I'm like, I call him up. I'm like, I have MS. I'm still have MS. He's like, you don't have MS. And then that ends that conversation. Then like a week before, I call him up and I'm like, Dad, I have prostate cancer. I have prostate cancer. He goes, how do you know? It's like, I don't know. It hurts down by my balls and stuff. And like, I think I have prostate cancer. It kind of hurts on my butt cheeks and stuff. And he's like, you don't have prostate cancer. I'm like, I do. And then I called him every day for a week. Just like, I have prostate cancer. I have prostate cancer. It's like, you're too young for prostate cancer. I mean, I know I have it. So I get off the plane when I go home. It's like 6 or 7 at night. And my father says, we're going to Bob Rosen's house to get you examined. This is a urologist friend of his. So he's taking me to a man's house to be examined for prostate cancer. So he picks me up at the airport. He's like, no, we're going now. I'm like, I don't think that's, why can't I just go to his office? No, you have prostate cancer. We're going to go now. So we drive to this guy's house. He doesn't know we're coming. So we walk up to the door. My father knocks on the door. And Bob literally is like, he shows up. He's got a napkin. He's wiping his mouth. I see his family's at the dinner table. My father goes, my son thinks he has prostate cancer. Can you take a look? And Bob's like, I don't know. What do you mean? He's like, well, come on in. And then he goes back to the table. He puts a napkin down. And then he walks me and my father into his bedroom. And we're all standing there. I'm like, this in any other situation would be illegal. Whatever's happening, whatever's about to happen, this is bad. And thank God Bob says, you know what? He should probably come to the office. I don't think this is the place to do this. And my father's like, are you sure? Is that all right with you, kid? I'm like, yeah, it's probably better. All right. So Bob didn't finger bang me in his bedroom. With my father watching, nonetheless. So this is how I cured my hypochondria. So I go to Bob's office, does the horrible examination. It's very difficult. It's, you know, when you're a man, this is, I know women have their thing, but I'm not a woman. I know that as a dude, I got to go in and get finger banged by a guy, you know, once a year in a clinical way. But it's always awkward. It's never a pleasant situation. The most awkward part about it is like you get to a certain age where it's about to happen and there it goes in and you're like, oh, I kind of get this. Wait, I'm not changing my life. So, but it does seem to do something. But okay, so he gives me the examination and then, you know, he diagnoses, you know, it's really hard. I don't want to go into it. It's too, but he does the examination. Turns out I had something. I had something, huh? Yay. I had some sort of prostatitis, which my dad gets to. It's some sort of, you know, sensitive to it or what. So I had something. Great. I was right. Now, what happens next is a week later, it's supposed to be gone, but I still feel it, right? So I go into Bob's office and I go, I think I still have it. He goes, no, you've been on antibiotics for 12 days. It's gone. I'm like, no, I'm pretty sure that I have it still. He's like, no, you don't have it. I'm like, I don't know. He goes, you want me to examine you again? If you have to. So he does it again. I do it again. I get finger banged by Bob Rosen again. Twice. Okay. So now, like, another week goes by. I'm about to go back to school, and I decide I have herpes on my cock. Now, the irony of this is I had not had sex. I'd somehow gotten it from something. It was a unique case. So I, you know, sad way, I probably just jerked off too hard. That was the sad part about it. Like, all right, anyways. Look, I didn't want to do this story. All right, so now I got to go back to Bob Rosen. So this is like, I've been at his house. I've been finger banged by him twice. And now a week later, I'm going back with herpes that isn't even there. So I go into Bob's office and I go, he's like, what's up? And I'm like, I'm pretty sure I got herpes. Have you had sex recently? No, I've never had it. And then how do you think you have? I just think I have herpes. And so he goes, all right, take your pants down. So I take my pants down and he sits down, he rolls up one of those chairs, you know, and he's got my cock in his hand. He's holding my cock. And he looks at it and he goes, you know, there's nothing here, Mark. Do you like coming here? That ended my hypochondriacal period. That was the end of that. Sealed. Nip that in the bud. I should tell you the Viagra story now. Has to do with another doctor. I have doctor things.